We want to determine the area under the function f of x equals 6 on the closed interval from 0 to 4 using a definite integral. So here's x equals 0, and here's x equals 4. We want to determine the area that is below the function and above the x-axis, which would be this shaded region here. Well, because this shaded region is a rectangle, we could just use the area formula for a rectangle, where the area is equal to length times width. So for this rectangle, the length here would be 6, and the width would be 4, and 6 times 4 is equal to 24 square units. So we know the area of this rectangle, but we actually want to start using calculus techniques to determine the area under functions. So let's start with a quick review. We've already learned that if a function is continuous and non-negative on an interval, as we see here, the area is equal to the limit as n approaches infinity of this sum. And the sum represents the area of very thin rectangles bounded by the function and the x-axis. And this is also equal to the definite integral from a to b of f of x with respect to x. And now the fundamental theorem of calculus gives us a more convenient way to evaluate definite integrals as long as we can determine the antiderivative of the integrand. The definite integral from a to b of f of x with respect to x is equal to the difference of the antiderivative function evaluated at b, the upper limit of integration, and evaluated at a, the lower limit of integration. So as long as we can determine the antiderivative, the fundamental theorem of calculus makes evaluating definite integrals very straightforward. So now let's go back to our example. Again, since this function is continuous and non-negative on this interval, the area is going to be equal to the definite integral from 0 to 4 of our function, which is 6, with respect to x. Well, the antiderivative of 6 would be 6x plus c, but for definite integration, we leave off the constant of integration because when we determine the difference, the constants of integration would cancel out anyway. So we'll evaluate 6x at 4 and then 0, then determine the difference. So we'll first replace x with 4 and then with 0. So we have an area of 24 square units, which we already knew. But using this calculus technique, we'll be able to determine area under functions where there isn't a geometric formula to determine the area. We'll take a look at several more examples in this series of videos.